Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and a few weeks ago, I went over a big change that's happening with Adobe products. Basically, they are not going to support Pantone swatches anymore. Yes, so there will be no Pantone swatches in the Adobe products going forward from March 2022, as far as I know. And I showed how to do a workaround with Pantone Connect and basically downloading the current swatches that are in your programs now. And I showed that with Adobe Illustrator. But I got a few requests about how to do that in other programs. So today I'm going to show you how to do it in Adobe Photoshop. Now, if you watched that other video, you're probably going to understand how Pantone Connect works and how to take the screenshot and all that. So you can just skip to this timestamp that's up here on your screen. And that way you can just learn how to download the swatches moving forward. Now, unfortunately, Photoshop does not have a way to kind of download the swatches like you can in Adobe Illustrator. So we are going to go to Adobe Illustrator, download the swatches over there, and then upload those swatches here in Photoshop. I know it's weird, but it is the best way that I know of to do it. Okay, so first is the Pantone Connect extension. You can just do a Google search for this. It'll be the one that ends in adobe.com. I'm gonna go here, and I'm also gonna leave this in the description below so you can just click on it. First, you'll need to sign in to your Creative Cloud account, and then you can just go to Install Now, and then hit OK. Now, I've already done this, so I'm going to go straight to Photoshop, and you'll need to just open a document. Then you can go to Window, Extensions, Legacy, and Pantone Connect. Now, you'll need to create an account for this if you haven't done so already. You'll have to do like the email verification and all that stuff, and then you'll need to sign in. And you might have to do like a one-question survey. Now, Pantone Connect is a paid app, but there is one little part of this app that we can use for free, and that is the color picker. So I'm going to come down here to colors and choose pick. Then if I click up here, I can choose the color book. I'm going to go with formula guide coded, and this is going to be kind of like solid coded. And I'm going to use the search and just type in 350. I want to look for Pantone 350. And so here it is right here. Now it looks like there's a little color picker here, but if we click on this color to send it over to our swatch, it's just going to take us to a paid screen and it's not going to work. So instead what we can do is just screenshot it. So I'm gonna do Shift, Control, Command, and the number 4. That's on a Mac, and that's going to do a screenshot copy. So I'm gonna draw a box around the green, and then I'll click on my document and hit paste. And I've got that green color right here. For Windows 10 and newer, you can press Shift, then the Windows key, and S. And all the options for screen grabs come up on the top of your screen. One of them is select a region. And once you've done that, it'll copy it just like we did here. It copies it to your clipboard, and then you can just paste it in the document, or you can click the notification to open what you grabbed and save it as a file. I don't really think you need to do that. You can just paste it in. Then I'm gonna get on my eyedropper by hitting the letter I. That's this tool right over here. I'll click on this, and then I'm gonna double click my color, and I'll choose Add to Swatches. And then I'll just name this Pantone 350C, and we'll say okay. So here it is in my swatches. So that's how to use the free version of Pantone Connect to get a new Pantone color swatch. So this is good for finding ones that don't currently exist in Photoshop. Now, doing it this way obviously takes some time, which I think if you purchase that app, it's a much faster process. You can just click using the eyedropper and automatically come over here, and you can add it to your swatches that way. Now, if you're worried that this green isn't exactly a Pantone color swatch, everything that's on your screen has always been just a representation anyway. A printer will actually need to match this Pantone 350 to a Pantone color book, a printed color book. And I actually have another video about how Pantone colors work. That should be at the top of your screen right now if you want to take a look. Now in March, we really don't know what's going to happen with the Pantone color books. I'm thinking we won't even be able to access what we have now in Photoshop 2022 and before. I want to show you a way to grab all the swatches and save them as a file that you can always bring up and search through and that kind of thing. Now, unfortunately in Photoshop, it's not easy and maybe not even possible to get an entire color book of colors into my swatch panel without clicking on every single swatch. So normally the way to bring up Pantone in is just to click your color, go to color libraries, and then just type, for example, 350, and it'll show up. Then you can click that, say okay, and it'll add it to your swatch right up here. And it'll change your color to that Pantone. So you would have to go through that process with however many colors there are. To save a file that has all the swatches in it, the best place to do that is in Illustrator. So now I'm in Illustrator, I'm gonna create new. It doesn't matter, just any document is fine. Then I'm gonna come over here to the swatches flyout. By the way, swatches are under your window, so they're right here. And then I'm gonna come over here to the flyout and choose select all unused, and then click on the trash can button and delete those. The next step is to come over to your swatch flyout, choose open swatch library, and then go to color books and find the Pantone book you want to open. Here's Pantone solid coated, and it'll open all of those swatches at once, which is really nice. So we want to click on the very first one and then scroll all the way to the bottom, hold shift, and click on the very last one. And then we'll click on this flyout and choose add to swatches. Now all of these swatches are in our swatches panel. So now we can come over here to this flyout and choose save swatch library as ASE. So I already have this one saved in here, but you can name it Pantone solid coated. I'm just gonna take that plus out so it'll be a different file, and we'll save and we'll say okay. Now I'll go back to Photoshop, and I'm going to come up here to the swatches. And first I'm going to delete all the swatches that are currently in there. So I'll select all those and just delete with the little trash can. And now I'll come up here to the flyout and choose import swatches. And here's the one that we just created. And if it's not taking you directly to the one you just saved, this is the path for Mac. So we have our little house, then library, application support, and then here are the rest to get down in there and find the swatch file. And we'll open. And now this comes in a nice little folder. So you can also have other swatches outside of this. And then if we toggle this down, you can see all the Pantones inside here. And then if you want to search for one, all you have to do is come up here to this little search bar and type in 350, and it'll automatically pull that one up. Now, if you're not seeing this little search bar, it's also under here and it's right here. You can just turn it on. So you can repeat that pattern for all the other swatch books, so they'll be available to you after March. So that takes care of all the older swatches, but for the new swatches, you can use Pantone Connect like I showed you before. Or you can bypass all of this and pay $7 a month for the Pantone Connect extension, which I've heard is a little buggy, so I definitely am not going to be doing that, and I don't use them that much anyway. But if it makes sense for you, go ahead and just buy the $7 extension. All right, I hope this video has helped you. If it has, please click on the subscribe button to see more videos like this. All right, I'll see you next week with another graphic design video. Thank you.